think I will start my slot now. Okay, so as you can see, this would be the first slide of the day. So how to improve your marks and self-editing process for writing. Okay, as I mentioned before, this is a great like exposure for you or even for the parents, okay, to prepare themselves for PSLE writing. Okay, now as you know, okay, I'm not sure whether some of you may or may not know that currently we have a few changes for English PSLE. okay, so for situational writing, okay, there will be a few changes, okay, in formatting, okay, for 2024 versus 2025 format. Right, now let's have a look at the table. Okay, as you can see, there are three boxes here, okay, so PSLE 2024, and then we have PSLE 2025, and then we have the remarks. Okay, so the marks that will be counted for both situational writing and continuous writing, okay, I'm sorry, let me just focus on situational writing first. Okay, the category or criteria that will be marked or assessed would be, first is the task fulfillment. Okay, thank you for those who just joined in. Okay, the first one is the task fulfillment, and then the second one is of course the language and organization. So for PSLE 2024, for PSLE this year, the marks for task fulfillment is 6 marks, while for the language organization is 9 marks. Okay, that would make the total for situational writing is 15 marks. Okay, so usually students will get full mark for the task fulfillment, which is they have to provide the points for their email or letter or even report based on the poster or pictures, okay, displayed for the situational writing. Okay, but for the language and organization, I'll talk about it later. Okay, but for PSLE 2025, okay, so technically the P5 2024 will be the first batch to use this kind of formatting. Okay, so now let's have a look. Let's take a look at the differences between PSLE 2024 and PSLE 2025 format. Okay, the first one is the task fulfillment. Okay, so it is still the same mark. Okay, PSLE 2025 with no change in marks, but in the task requirement. Okay, which I will be talking about together with the sample later. Okay. And then for the language and organization, okay, PSLE, this year's PSLE, 2024 PSLE, the mark is 9 marks. But for PSLE 2025, the mark is only 8. Okay, so change in mark only, which means one mark, deduction of 1 mark from the language and organization for PSLE 2025. Okay, so in total, in PSLE 2024, it is 15 marks, okay, while in PSLE 2025, it would be only 14 marks. So, deduction of 1 mark to be given to oral, okay? Now, let's have a look at the situational writing 2024 format, okay? Just now, I mentioned to you that there is a change in task requirement for 2025 PSLE. Okay, now let's have a look at the formatting. So this would be the 2024 format, okay, this year's format. Now let me zoom in for you. Just let me know if the poster is not in your screen or you can't see the screen. All right, so this is the example or sample of 2024 format for situational writing. Let me just zoom in for you. Okay, so the picture below the picture below shows what you saw during your stay at the school. So this can be described as comic strips, okay? 19 April 2023, okay, at 11 a.m. in library, okay? You see there are two students here. So this Lisa girl informed Liam. So Liam, don't forget to switch off the fans, okay? Make sure there is no one here before you lock the door. So Liam said, all right, Lisa, no problem. Okay, and then on to the second one. So 19 April 2023, 12:15 p.m. in the library, okay? So, yeah, it's about like almost 45 minutes later, okay? Then what did Liam see? Liam see that this boy here is crying and then another boy is trying to punch the crying boy, okay? Let's call it as boy A and then boy B, okay? So what did Liam do? Liam said, hey, stop, okay? Now on to the third picture. 19 April 2023, 12:20 p.m. So it took about like 5 minutes, okay, outside of the school. Okay, we can see that boy A, the one who tries to punch the crying boy, is running from the school. Okay, now let's read your task, okay, as a student. What do they need from you? So your task, imagine you are Liam, okay? Who is Liam? Liam is the guy who saw everything, okay? Imagine you are Liam. Write an email to Mr. Alan Tay, the principal of your school, to inform him of the incident. You are to refer to the pictures and information on the previous page of for your report. Sorry, this should be for your email, okay? Now, in your email, include the following key information. So we have 4 bullet points, but we know that in the task fulfillment here, you see, in order for you to get full marks, you have to provide 6 points in your email, okay? But there are only 4 bullets, so that's what you need to do is you need to read the bullet points carefully, okay? For the first one, what were you doing at the library? So that would be your first point, okay? The date and time of the accident, so that would be your second point. 2 things you see, third and fourth point. 2 details of each boy, that would make the 5th and 6th points, okay? You may reorder the points and remember to write it in complete sentences. So you don't have to follow the sequence, okay? You can jump from what were you doing at the library and then you go to the details of each boy and then you can go to the date and time of the accident or incident and then you can go back to the 2 things you see, okay? It doesn't mean that you have to follow the sequence, okay? Now, so that would make the 6 points, all the 6 points to be put in the email, okay? And as always, since you are going to email this email to Mr. Alan T, which is the principal, you know that it is gonna be a formal email, okay, which you should avoid. Contraction, okay, where you shorten your words, okay? Now, that is the 2024 formatting. Moving on to the 2025 formatting. Okay, let me go back to the task fulfillment, okay? Just now, I did mention for the task fulfillment, even though it is still the same marks, 6 marks for PSLE 2024 and PSLE 2025, no change in marks but in task requirement. So what kind of changes do they make? Now let's see. So this poster is still the same. It's about Lisa asking Liam to don't forget to switch off the fans, and then you have to make sure that no one's here before you lock the door. And then it's still the same where Liam saw this boy A trying to punch boy B, and then boy B is crying, and then boy A is running from the school. Sorry. Now let's have a look at the task. Okay. See, the task is still the same. Okay, imagine you are Liam. Write an email to Mr. Alan Tay, the principal of your school, to inform him of the incident. Okay, you are to refer to the picture and information on the previous page. But let's have a look at the bullet. Okay, so we still have four bullet points. Okay, but you see, what were you doing at the library? Okay, you as Liam, so that would be the first point. The date and time of the accident. Okay, second point, two details of each boy. Okay, that would make the third and fourth points, and two things you did. Okay, so in this poster, it did not mention about anything that Liam did. Okay, so this is the changes in the task fulfillment. Okay, the task requirement. Okay, you need to, in order for you to answer point 5 and 6, what you need to do is you need to understand this poster first, and you need to think creatively, okay, of what you should do or what you did, okay, after you saw what happened here. Okay, boy A is bullying boy B. Okay, so two things that you did is what you need to think of. Okay, it is not in the poster, but you have to think based on your understanding from the poster. Okay, and of course you may reorder the points. Okay, now let's have a look at the answer. Oops. Yes, I'm gonna just zoom out. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in. Okay, this is still the same poster. Now let's have a look at the formatting and how are you going to answer this new 2025 formatting. Okay, of course, whenever you encounter this situational writing, you should know the basic tip or technique, okay, or method on how are you going to construct your email, your letter, or your report. Okay, the first one would be your PAC. Okay, your purpose, your audience, and your context. Okay, so now imagine you are Liam, so you would be the writer. Okay, so you have to sign off the email or the letter, but in this case it's the letter. Okay, you have to sign off the letter with Liam, okay, with a name of Liam, not your own name. All right, okay, and then since you know who is the reader, so you should sign off your email with yours sincerely, Liam Chen. Okay, you should use your full name. So write an email to Mr. Alan Tay, the principal of your school. So the audience or your reader would be Mr. Alan Tay, okay? To inform him of the incident. So that is the purpose of you writing a formal email to Mr. Alan Tay, all right? Now, in your email, include the following key information. So context would be formal email because you are sending it to your principal. Okay, so what were you doing at the library would be the first point. Okay, the date and time of the accident is point 2. Two details of each boy, point 3 and point 4. And two things you did, point 5 and 6, which is the critical thinking point. Okay, it is up to you to come up with what you did, but as long as it is acceptable, okay, and make sure that you fully understand what the poster is about. Okay, now let's go to the answer. Sorry, the sample answer. I'm so sorry. Okay. Let me just zoom out first. Okay. I hope you can see all of the passage. Let me just move my phone a bit. Okay. Now, dear Mr. Alan Tay, I hope this email finds you well. I'm writing to report an incident that took place in the school library on 19 April 2023 between 11 a.m. and 12:20 p.m. At the time, I was on duty to ensure that all electrical appliances were switched off, the doors were secured, and no one remained in the library after school hours. While I was walking through the book aisles, I witnessed a bullying incident in front of the reception desk. A primary 5 boy was about to punch a much younger primary 1 boy. The primary 1 boy appeared distressed and was crying. He seemed very shaken by the situation. The bully, a primary 5 student, was dressed in a black school shirt and was quite aggressive during the confrontation. I immediately acknowledged the crying boy and attempted to chase the bully, but he ran away so swiftly that I was unable to catch up with him. I lost sight of him at the school gate. After the incident, I made sure to comfort the younger boy and report the matter as soon as possible. I hope you can investigate this matter further and take appropriate action to identify and address the bullying incident. Thank you for your time and attention to this matter. Kind regards, Liam Chen. Okay, now let's have a look at the points. You see, I hope this email finds you well. I'm writing to report an incident that took place in the school library on 19 April 2023 between 11:30 a.m. and 12:20 p.m. So that is the what? Again, I'm so sorry. I am just zooming in, and when I want to move to the task, it straight away refresh my page. Okay, now let me just move my phone a bit. Okay, so that is point number 2, as mentioned in the answer here. You see, point 2, not 22, I'm sorry. Okay, at the time I was on duty to ensure that the electrical appliances were switched off, okay, the doors were secured. Okay, so that is point number 1, asking you what were you doing at the library. Okay, and then point number three asks you the 2 details of each boy. Okay, so these are the 2 details of each boy. You see, the primary 1 boy appeared distressed and was crying. Okay, point number two, he seemed very shaken by the situation. Okay, and then the details of another boy. Okay, the details of the bully, right? The bully, a primary 5 student, was dressed in a black school shirt and was quite aggressive during the confrontation. Okay, so that is the 2 details of each boy. Okay, and lastly, the 2 things that you did where you have to use your own critical thinking based on your own understanding from the poster. Okay, so the answer is first action is I acknowledged the crying boy and attempted to chase the bully. but he ran away so swiftly, so I wasn't able to catch up with him. Okay, so that is the first action. The second action was I made sure to comfort the younger boy and report the matter as soon as possible. Okay, and the signing off should be yours sincerely, okay? Because you know your reader's name is Mr. Alan Tay. But what about if you do not know the name of your reader? For example, like you do not know the name of the president of your community center. So you should sign, if you do not know the name of the reader or your audience, okay, you should sign off with yours faithfully, okay? Now, moving on to the next slide, okay? So, in order for you to get higher mark for your language and organization, okay, you should make use of these words, okay? Connectors in English, okay? Connectors are used to join and make your sentences smoother, okay? For example, like addition, contrast, cause and effect, time, sequence, example, and emphasis. Okay, you can make use of these blue wordings. Okay, now let's go to the next one. This is what I mentioned when you write like a formal email or formal letter, you should avoid using contraction. Okay, so this is what I meant by contraction, where you shorten the words. Okay, for example, like I am, you say I am, alright? You can make use of it during informal letter, during you want to, you know, create your informal letter or informal email, but try to minimize it, okay? And then of course, you cannot just end your writing abruptly, okay? So you have to use phrases like, I hope you will, you know, take action, or I look forward to reading your reply, okay, and thank you for your kind attention to end your writing. Not just, you know, when you want to send this to your principal, you don't include this. I hope you can investigate this matter further, okay? You just end it abruptly up until point six, and then you just sign off, okay? Try not to do that, okay? Now, I hope we still have time to complete our continuous writing, okay? Because we have only 8 minutes left, okay? Now, for continuous writing, okay? Just now we talked about the differences between PSLE 2024 and 2025 for situational writing. Now we are going to talk about continuous writing. Okay, so for PSLE 2024, the content is 20 marks. Language is also 20 marks, which makes the total of continuous writing 40 marks, okay? But for PSLE 2025, the content and the language has the change in marks, okay? Deduction of 2 marks, okay? For both content and language, which makes the total of continuous writing for PSLE 2025 is 36 marks, okay? So where do the 4 marks go? The 4 marks deduction of 4 marks will be given to the oral paper 4, okay? So both content and language for continuous writing only change in marks, okay? No other changes, right? Now let's have a look at the continuous writing sample and how you can maximize your marks, okay? So for continuous writing, this is how the question look like, okay? Now, continuous writing, 40 marks. We have 40 marks here. But in PSLE 2025, it would be only 36 marks, okay? So write a composition of at least 150 words about a dangerous situation, okay? So this is some typo, okay? Your composition should be based on one or more of these pictures, okay? So your children or you yourself have the option to make use of all the three, or just two, or only one. But make sure if you make use of, let's say for example, if you make use of all the three pictures, make sure that you describe each picture in detail, okay, thoroughly, right? Because we don't want to lose mark. Because you choose the picture but you did not describe it, so you will lose mark because of that. Okay, consider the following points when you plan your composition. What was the situation and why was it dangerous? Okay, now let's have a look at the tapes. All right, I'm just gonna zoom. Okay, now tips for continuous writing is in the first section, which is the introduction. Okay, so we have 5 stages of writing. Okay, introduction, and then we have the rising action, and then we have climax, falling action, and conclusion. Okay, so for continuous writing, what you need to do is during your introduction section, you should be able to introduce your characters as well as your setting. Okay, setting means the time and the place. Okay, time, for example, last Saturday morning, it was a hot, scorching hot morning. Okay, for example, and then you introduce your characters. There are how many characters in your story? There are 3. Okay, so you should be able to name them, you should be able to describe their physical traits, or maybe if you cannot think of anything, you can think of the clothes they are wearing, what about their hair, okay, their complexion, okay, and then you introduce the first problem. Okay, so in any story there must be a problem, there must be a conflict to make it more interesting, to make your readers, you know, feel more appealing. Okay, thank you Fatin Liana for joining in. Okay, then you have the what? Rising action. Rising action is a series of events, okay, as a result from your conflict, which will lead you to the climax. Okay, what is a climax? Climax is the most peak part of your story, the most dramatic part of your story, and then you go to the falling action, where you what? Where by that time, by that stage, all your conflicts, all your problems need to be resolved, and then you are going to lead to the conclusion part, okay, where you tell the readers whether you learn something, or you know, you make sudden realization, okay, something like that. Now this is the sample for continuous writing. I cannot read it for you because it is we don't have enough time, but let's have a look at this. You see, I've already highlighted it, some of the points for you. You see, the first one, it was shady and cool in the forest even though the sun was hot, luminous ball in the sky. John, Ali, Mingtan and I were trekking through it. The forest hummed with the sound of crickets and chirping birds. Okay, you see, so from the first line, these 2 lines has already what mentioned or described about the setting, which is the time and place, together with the introduction of the characters. Okay, and then you see, this is also explaining or elaborating or describing about the characters. You see, can we stop for a short rest? Wheezed John, breathing heavily. His round face was pink with exertion and dripping with perspiration. So based on our reading, we know, we can technically imagine, okay, how John looked like. Okay, and then here comes the problem. You see, a wild boar stood not far ahead of us. It was snorting and pacing the jungle path. You see, they just want to spend some time with friends, but there was a wild boar stood not far ahead of them. Okay, now here comes the conflict. Okay, first they have the problem, now the conflict. You see, I guess panic must have clouded Ming Chat's mind, because the next second he staggered backwards, turned and ran blindly down the path. Help, help, he howled, arms and legs flailing furiously as expected, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so this is the conflict. So if your, for example, your friends are, you know, telling the same story, but if you include conflict, it would be different from the rest of your friends, which would maximize or gain you more marks if you add this conflict. Okay, now on to the resolution. Okay, you see, this gave Mingtai a few seconds he needed to shin up a tree. John came dashing up, another sandwich in his hand, which he waved in the direction of the wild boar. Okay, so this is how they or the writer resolved the conflict, okay, with the help of John. And then in the end, you see, conclusion. Mingtai apologized sheepishly for allowing fear to get the better of him. We turned to John and thumped him on his back. After all, he had been the hero of the day with his quick thinking action. And ironically, the harrowing encounter with the wild boar had turned the trek into one of our most memorable adventures. So this is how the writer and the writing. Okay, so I guess that is the end of my slot. Okay, so I hope we can have another session of this kind of slots. Okay, and by the way, I'm not sure, but I think we have another slot, but with different subjects. Okay, not only English, we have Malay, we have mathematics, we have science. Okay, just make sure to follow our social media. Okay, at EduFrontSG. Okay, don't forget to like this TikTok account. Okay, and then share this slot. Okay, I'm sure that you would gain at least, you know, a think of or two about how to improve your marks and self-editing process for writing. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. Bye-bye.